If eyes are windows to the soul, then Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sigurlitsy are doing some serious soul searching right now. Last night in St. John, the two Russians did not skate like world champions. They stumbled, struggled, yet were still rewarded with first place after the short program. Right behind them, Canada's Sargent and Wirtz. 5 years have passed without a Skate Canada win. Tonight, they take dead aim at gold and the world champions. To the oldest incorporated city in Canada for the 1999 Sun Life Skate Canada International. Welcome to St. John, New Brunswick. Well, it's November and it's the start of the skating season. And hi, everybody, I'm Rod Black. And tonight our coverage continues here at the Sun Life Skate Canada International. Last night we blasted from the starting gates thanks to an outstanding men's short program, and Elvis Stoiko did it again on home ice. I know it's early in the season, but Stoiko already setting the tone early. Quadruple jump, first time ever that he had performed it in a short program. He brought the house down again last night, and he was looking good. And already battle lines are drawn with the world champion, Alexei Yagudin. Stoiko is in second place, but close behind the world champion Yagudin of Russia, who also landed a quadruple jump in the short program. Yagudin, the leader right now. Elvis Stoiko has won 5 Skate Canada titles. This is Yagudin's first trip to a Skate Canada. Yagudin won at Skate America last week. Stoiko was third. We'll have the men's free skate tomorrow night. Tonight, it's the pairs free skate, and there is some concern surrounding the camp of the world champions, who are having all kinds of trouble right now. Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sigurlitsy aren't skating well and not communicating either. In fact, today Anton showed up at practice, but Elena did not. They made 4 errors last night in their short program. They still had strong enough presentation marks, however, to be elevated into first place, just ahead of Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz, the Canadian champions, who could strike gold here tonight. Debbie Wilkes will be by with the call of that. She'll also have an investigative report a little bit later on a Canadian judge who's recently suspended, trying to save her name and her reputation. Now, Tracy Wilson is with me for the original dance, which starts off the night. Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz aren't here because they're going to skate next week. But we have an interesting field, don't we?
Yes, we do, including 2 fine Canadian teams and our second and third ranked team in Canada. And I think there's a very good chance we will see a Canadian dance team on the podium here at Skate Canada. The competition got underway yesterday with a compulsory dance. It was the Yankee Polka. And here's a look at Canada's second-ranked team, Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe. They finished in 5th place after this dance. This dance is worth 20% of the total mark. Canada's third-ranked team, Dubray and Lausanne, had a really good skate. They're sitting in 4th place, but just behind 3rd. It was a close competition. And the winners of the Yankee Polka from Lithuania, Drobiazko and Vanagas, and they're ranked 6th at the World Championships. But you know, Rod, one of my favorite teams by virtue of the fact that they're both strong, strong skaters.
And boy, do they have a lot of fun out on the ice. Margarita Drobiazko, Pavelis Vanagas, the leaders heading into the original dance tonight. And again, we'll be watching the Canadians, Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lausanne, just ahead of Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe. Before we get it started, let's get a word from Rob Falls, who's backstage.
Coming up later in the show, we've got a feature on Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lausanne. The Quebec ice dancing team is in 4th place after the compulsories. This is the team that actually considered retirement a short while ago. They were having some financial troubles, but things are slowly starting to turn around for them. Not only did they receive the Elvis Stoiko grant, they have also been given a donation of ice time from the town of Boisbriand. That is where they train, just outside of Montreal. Slowly but surely for this Quebec team, things are turning around.
Well, Robbie, sometimes we forget about the sacrifices that skaters and teams have to make. Here is How will show you the original dance tonight, wing and low first. Margarita Drobiazko, Pavlis Vanagas, the leaders, skate third, and followed by Marie-France Debray, Patrice Lazon, and then the Ukrainian team last to skate tonight in St. John.
Represent Canada, Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe.
Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe find themselves in fifth position after the compulsory dance.
Last year, the original dance was 2 minutes. Megan and Aaron move from a samba to a rumba. Excellent transition to the music. Original dance was one tempo. And I really like this new addition that they change tempos. Adds a variety to the performance. Edges, smooth. There are required elements. The skaters must execute two lifts. You just saw one of them. They must also do a circular footwork sequence, straight line one. Straight line footwork sequence. And what you'll notice that's different from any other year, this is the first time dancers have been allowed to skate apart. In other years, they had to be arm in arm. Excellent chance to size up the quality of both skaters on their own.
Vancouver's Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe. For so long, they have been third in Canada. They've had a chance to skate all around the world, but their goal is to get to the Worlds.
Aaron Lowe, who
decided this year to go to the Detroit Figure Skating Club, make a move, change coaches, and they have.
And that's Igor Spielban sitting with them. They also train with Liz Coates, and I believe they're an excellent team of coaches. Liz works on the technique, Igor does the choreography, always have well-trained skaters. Here's a look at the footwork sequence I was telling you about. See how they're skating far apart? They can be as far as two arm lengths apart. Never before have ice dancers ever been allowed to do that. And what has happened in the past is you have one strong partner who does all the work, and the weaker partner will skate on 2 feet and just follow them. But here the skaters must do difficult footwork. There's their twizzle section. They have to execute a twizzle section, which is where you're spinning on one foot. I love this. I think it adds a whole new dimension to the dance, and I just think it's a step in the right direction for the International Skating Union's Dance Committee.
What I like about these two young people is the fact that they're so resilient. So often they've been held down, so often they felt that maybe, you know, are we going in the right direction? But they continue to do it, and they have a chance this year to finally make it to the world team.
And they have a great attitude this year, Rod. They're looking at how they can improve. He said, I know we may have had a little bit of tight moment in the Yankee Bowl, but I know how we can improve. They're thinking ahead, and that's the attitude that you need to move in this sport.
There are the marks that will set the standard tonight.
Tonight's competitors represent France. Isabelle Delabelle and Olivier Chantelder.
Beginning the night two places ahead of Wing and Low of Canada, this team from France, Isabelle Delabelle and Olivier Chantelder.
They are ranked 14th in the world, but Patrice Lausanne and Marie-France Dubray beat them at an international last year, so the Canadian teams are competitive with these two. Just looking for originality in the dance lifts. Samba, I really like their energy, Rod, but I find that they're digging in with their toe picks. It makes it noisy and it looks scratchy and a little bit rough. It's something that has to be addressed for this team to move into the top 10.
number of strong dance teams from France. This is one of them. Isabelle Delabelle and Olivier Schoenfelder began the night in third place. Their marks in a moment. And still ahead, one of the Canadian teams, Marie-France Debray and Patrice Lauzon. It is one of the biggest events on the planet. The World Cup of Rugby, and it's tomorrow on CTV Sportsnet. Australia against France, 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 o'clock Pacific time. And I'm sure these two kids will be cheering for their compatriots.
Cheering for France. Can't get more of a contrast than that, from rugby to ice dance. This team sitting 14th in the world in this competition, just ahead of Canadians, Dubray and Lauzon. Good energy, a dynamic team. They train with the legendary coach Tatiana Tarasova. She brings out a lot of energy and emotion in her pupils. Taking a look at one of the dance lifts, they have to do two, and one rotates, the other must change edges. Little bit rough, but well skated.
Marks for it.
So now the marks.
And Olivier Schoenfelder for composition.
For composition.
5-2, 5-1.
Stronger than
5-1,
wing
5-1,
and low.
5-1, 5-0.
And for presentation.
5-2, 5-0.
The next set of marks upcoming, and once
5-4,
again stronger
5-4,
than wing
5-4,
and low. So Delabelle and Schoenfelder first so 5-2, far.
5-4,
Megan
5-4,
Wing and Aaron Lowe currently
5-4,
in second place.
5-3. 5-2. Our next competitors represent Lithuania, Margarita Drobiazko and Pavlis Vadegas.
Here are the leaders after the compulsories. Longtime visitors to Canada and this competition, they have enjoyed a steady rise in the dance world. Currently ranked number 6, Margarita Drobiazko and Pavlis Vadegas.
They start out slowly with a rumba and then move to the samba. Skaters. In fact, Povilas was a Lithuanian national champion in singles 6 times before he switched to dance. Dance spin.
Thank you.
They are crowd pleasers, Lithuanian champions, Margarita Drobiazko and Pavelis Vanagas. Leaders after the compulsories, their marks after this.
When I'm submerged in my studies, I don't always eat right. That's why I take Centrum every day for complete vitamin and mineral support. I study the science of the sea, but I trust the science of Centrum. It helps make my day complete.
With a garden like this, it's my diet that can get neglected. So I take Centrum every day for complete vitamin and mineral support. I'm learning the science of horticulture, but I trust the science of Centrum. It helps make my day complete.
Everyone's going to the Walmart anniversary event, where Rock and Roll Elmo and Ernie are $28.88 each. All Boys Parkas $34.96 and Pantsaver Car Mats $4.23. You just won't find a better deal anywhere else. Only until November 7th.
Have signs everywhere. Signs that they're committed. Signs that they're determined to leave their mark. Signs that they want to be part of something bigger. And soon our retailers will have a new sign as Ford and Mercury become one, offering the entire Ford family of vehicles. It's not a big thing, just more ways for them to meet the needs of the community they call home.
Captioning on CTV is brought to you in part by Hershey's Kisses. Little Hershey's Kisses. Big chocolate taste.
Nice performance from Drobiazko and Vanagas. This new rule that allows side-by-side individual skating in the original dance maybe benefits this team more than any other because they're such strong individual skaters.
That's true, Rod, but I don't think they took full advantage of it. In fact, I was a little bit disappointed in their straight line footwork. This lift, I thought, was excellent in the way it went to the music, and it just kept in with the flow and the rhythm of the dance. But when you were mentioning the straight line footwork, these two are such fine skaters. I thought it was slow and a little bit rough. The unison wasn't quite on. For the caliber that these two are capable of, perhaps here they're showing that it's a little bit early in the season. They're very capable of moving into the top five in the world. They're going to have to work on that if they're to do that.
For composition,
finished sixth at the 1999 World Championships. There are the marks for composition. Very strong from 5.4s to 5.7s. Good enough to keep them in first place, at least for the moment. First place ordinals across the board for Drobiazko and Vanagas. And let's go backstage to Rob Fox.
Rod, last year was a tough season for Quebec ice dancers Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lauzon. They came agonizingly close to taking a medal at the Canadian Championships, but a serious tumble cost them a medal and they finished up in fourth place. In fact, they even considered retiring, saying that they'd had enough of figure skating. But they took time in the summer, regrouped, and then said they felt inspired to carry on.
I can say we didn't have much money after this season. You know, we gave it everything, and
but it didn't work. You know, it kind of worked. If I hadn't fallen, maybe I would be where I want to be. I have to get past this, you know. I have to focus on the reason why we're skating. I wake up every morning at 5 and I try to think, I love what I'm doing. My job is fun. I do it with the person I love.
Their unison on the ice came naturally, but their resources ran dry.
It's hard when you you wake up every day and you think, maybe I won't be able to go tomorrow because I don't have money to put gas in my car. It's really hard.
Last spring, they were the recipients of the Elvis Stoico Fund, which granted them $5,000 each and a chance to prepare for this season.
We worked with this choreographer. She helped us a lot. She really touched a point in my heart where I just exploded. It was, I guess, too many things that I was hiding in myself, and she just put the finger on the button. And it really helped me in my training. From there, my training went.
You have to keep this very strong, so when you pull him, then it's already there. Otherwise, you have to do all the motions to get him up. Bam, 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 yes.
The physics is there. Anybody can skate to that level. The way you skate in your head, yeah. the way you present yourself, it's the way you think of you and your partner. You have to think that you're the best all the time, and that's what we're working on.
Our next competitors represent Canada, Marie-France Debrouille and Patrice Lauzon.
So here is a team that is making some noise and could make some big noise this season at the national championships. Marie-France Debrouille and Patrice Lauzon currently in fourth position here at Skate Canada.
They turned a lot of heads on the international scene last year, defeated the French team that is sitting in third place in this competition, but had a nasty fall at Canadians. Didn't make the world team. Selection of rhythms, a rumba, merengue, and samba. Right off the top, their speed is noticeable to me. Skating right into the ice, getting a lot of power, as fast as any team we've seen. Got caught in her skirt, and because of that they missed half of their circular footwork, and that's disastrous for them in this program. And Rod, the music also is not coming through in this building. It sounds very muffled. footwork. Good unison, good speed.
Well, give them credit for being able to hang on and pull through, but they are the hard luck kids. A fall at the national championships cost them third place. They had a tumble in warm-up tonight and then some costume problems. At least it's early in the season, and they don't want to see that happen at the national championships again. We'll see what the judges have to say about Marie-France Debray and Patrice Lauzon in a minute.
1 hour figure skating lesson, $55. Black spandex ensemble, $175. Cleaning, filling, and caps, $850. Discovering your artistic side, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's MasterCard. Accepted at figure skating schools and other artistic places worldwide.
Let's take a look now at the beginning of their program. Good unison. Very, very smooth. They aren't reaching for each other. Unfortunately, though, what I'm noticing with these two is they're skating better in practice than in the actual competition. And here they were hampered by her skirt. Her blade got caught in it. You can see there it's stuck. Now she has to stop, slow down. It really detracted from their circular footwork. They will be penalized for that. But like you said, Rod, this is a competition where if you want it to happen here so they can address it by the time they get to the Canadian Championships. Side-by-side footwork, good choreography. See their twizzle section there. They skated that well, and they were able to finish up the program selling it.
And that is something that can be corrected, the costume, can it?
Absolutely.
Anything like that happened to you when you were competing?
Not in a competition of this level, fortunately. It's just so disappointing for these two because they're not getting what they deserve. Fine team, and very disappointing.
So far, these marks in this competition staying pretty much status quo as compared to the compulsories. Marie-France Debray and Patrice Lauzon currently are third.
5-3, 5-1. Thank you. And as competitors representing Ukraine, Elena Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov.
So now after that misfortune to Debray and Lauzon, who had a chance of moving up, here comes the team ranked second heading into the original dance from Ukraine, Elena Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov.
Found something on the ice. Feather sequin. They are ranked eighth in the world, 13th in the world the year before. Great speed they have, and they sell every move they make. Quickly. They're skating with a lot of confidence. Skating to a samba, a rumba, a waltz. They skate it in the same way. They have one expression. Whatever rhythm or whatever mood they're trying to portray, it ends up that every program they do looks the same. But as I said, they are where they are because of their speed and the confidence with which they skate.
So if you were their coach, you'd change their expression?
You can only try. Straight line footwork. There is no reason why the Canadian team shouldn't be battling it out with these two. I see very little that separates them.
Except maybe the costume glitch that happened to Debray and Lauzon tonight. Last dance team of the night, Elena Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov. And where will the judges stack them? They began the night in second place. This Ukrainian team trains in Delaware with the Russians, Lobacheva and Averbuch, and Krylova and Ovsyannikov. However, at the rink in the next couple of weeks, it might be pretty empty because both of those teams are injured right now.
You can see they have a similar style, too, in the way that they sell their programs. Very intricate programs. That's Natalia Linenchuk, their choreographer, who makes their programs that way. Here's one of the lifts. But it's such an opportunity with the change of rhythm in this dance to really slow down and express the movement of the rumba. And that the movement comes from the hips, and it should be subtle and edgy. And I just felt that they kept going from beginning to end in the same manner.
Marks for, yes. So the marks now for Grushina Goncharov.
Composition
marks.
5-0.
And it looks like the judges are just going to hold the line.
I have to say, Rod, though, the marks that Debray and Lauzon would have had without that mistake would have put them in the same ball game, and that's a positive sign.
We'll have to see what happens in the free dance, which is tomorrow night, so not too much change from top to bottom in this field. Grushina and Ruslan Goncharov, second after the original dance and the compulsory. The Lithuanians lead the way towards the free dance. Isabelle Delabelle, Olivier Schoenfelder third. Marie-France Debray and Patrice Lauzon. What an unfortunate circumstance with the costume problem. And Megan Wing and Aaron Lowe in fifth place. Now let's join Rob Falls backstage.
Well, at least you're still smiling. It has been a difficult evening. First in warm-up and then catching your skirt with your toe pick. It's trying to teach you something, I think, through this all, isn't it?
Yeah, lots of different experience, I would say. No, that it's stuff that happens. I mean, I had to keep going and smile and pretend nothing happened. That's what we tried to do.
You're showing a lot more confidence, too. You seem a lot more confident on the ice.
Yeah, but it's something that we really try to be working on. It's to be more confident that we're the best out there, and there's nothing that can touch us, and we're strong and powerful and all good things.
Can you feel it getting better and better each time you get on the ice?
Of course, yeah. We use the energy of the crowd to push us through our programs, and I don't know, it was still good today. We had fun doing it, so, you know, it's just another experience.
Like the freedom.
Thank you.
You have an idea that this team doesn't let anything get it down. When we come back, the pairs free skate in St. John, New Brunswick on CTV, Canada's Figure Skating Network. St. John, New Brunswick, and skating fans across Canada bracing for the pairs free skates straight ahead at the Sun Life Skate Canada International. And for the second straight week, Canada could upset the world champions. Last week in Colorado, it was Jamie Soleil and David Pelletier winning Skate America. This week, it could be Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz. While the Canadians are skating well, Elena Berezhnaya and Anton Sigurlitsy of Russia are not. They did not skate well last night in the short program. They came unwound. Four errors, but they did get marked high on presentation, so they do sit first heading into the free skate. And then afterwards, some telling signs. They look like the Bickersons backstage. And then this morning, Elena did not show up for practice. Anton did. He could not skate without his partner, and all he could do was address the problems these two are having right now.
But, you know, we can't understand. Tamara can't understand. Elena can't understand also. But I think it's all together make a big snowball, and he's going down from the hill, no? And yeah, now we don't have enough power to stop him. And, you know, usually I never thought about, you know, the long program, short program. And now I think maybe I don't have enough power to skate the long program. You know, it's growing here, and after I say, it's no way, you know. I can skating on one leg the whole program, you know. Yeah. Everybody, not just I am. Yeah. Everybody, because we have enough power for five programs like this. Crazy things.
Well, actions and words speak volumes. Debbie is a former pairs champion. I know that people can't get along all the time, but is this supposed to happen to world champions?
Well, you're right. Everybody has problems once in a while, and you can't always guarantee a good skate. This early in the season, consistently good performances are hard to come by. But for this team, who normally, with their experience, should be able to rise above the problems, this is very serious.
So how do they regroup and get back? And the second question, how can the Canadians benefit from the fact that the Russians aren't skating well right now?
Elena and Anton have to go home, really train hard. They look unprepared, unlike the Canadians. Now, no one at this point in the year is physically really skating in top form, but you see the kind of emotional impact these failures have on Elena and Anton. And of course, the rest of the field, particularly the Canadians, sniff a win, and that's good for everybody.
So here is the order of skate tonight. Here in St. John, two Canadian teams, Jacinta LaRiviere and Lenny Faustino, then Valerie Sorette and Jean-Sebastien Fecteau, followed by the Americans, Ina and Zimmerman, then Sargent and Wirtz, the Chinese pair, and finally, last to skate, Berezhnaya and Sigurlitsy.
Our next competitors representing Canada, Jacinta LaRiviere and Lenny Faustino.
So welcome live inside Harbour Station. Beautiful rink here in St. John. Hosted Skate Canada a few years ago, recently a World Junior Championship, and here are two people who skated at that Junior Worlds in 97, Jacinta LaRiviere and Lenny Faustino.
This is just their second year as seniors. They're looking to be more polished and more mature this year, with more speed and more detail in their choreography. Setting up for the triple twist. Nice and clean. Great start. Bumpy combination. Jacinta only singling the double axel. Mm-hmm.
She is worried with two failures on the single jumps. Will she do the throw triple loop yet? Oh, touchdown almost.
Back in 1997 in December when the World Junior Championships were here and this team represented Canada, they finished seventh. They finished eighth here in the short program.
Most of the difficult jump elements out of the way. Here's a look at their best move. A beautiful star lift in reverse position. Good ice coverage. Got the throw triple salchow. Starting to settle down. Produced program in terms of the music. It's the soundtrack from A Midsummer Night's Dream. I think it really holds together well when skaters choose music from a similar album or from the same album. Outside death spiral, I think the best one in the competition. Long, beautifully positioned, and a strong element to end the 4.5 minute program.
I think they have to be extremely happy at their first major international competition, only their second season as seniors here at Skate Canada. Up and comers, La Riviere and Faustino, and their marks after this. NHL news tonight. Back at Harbour Station, the pairs free skate at the Sun Life Skate Canada International.
Jacinth and Lenny started out strongly with the twist, but with errors in the side-by-side jumps, this throw triple loop almost made it. Okay. Let's look at it again. The loop takeoff on the right back outside edge, three rotations in the air, great height, landing on the same foot.
Yeah, what are you gonna do?
Jacinth's balance slightly off. She had to touch down. Better than a fall. And here a look at the back outside death spiral, again named back outside because of the edge that the woman is skating on. Nice long edge. Now look at how his toe reaches back in behind. The man must be in pivot position, balanced on that back toe for at least one rotation. A smooth and beautiful element.
Good young team, Jacinth just 18, Lenny is 20. They were seventh, make that sixth last season at the national championships, and Come Calgary in the new year, they'll be right up there in the running. Their marks for technical merit. Second set for presentation.
The marks for presentation.
And they currently are in second place with a couple of teams having already skated.
5-0, 5-2, 5-2.
Pretty good.
4-8, 5-4.
Interesting the tactic that most teams will take about front loading the program.
Our next competitors.
When you say front loading, what do you mean by that?
Putting all the tough stuff in the first minute. If you nail them, it's great. If you don't, you scare yourself.
Another Canadian team, Valerie Sorette and Jean-Sébastien Fecteau, currently in sixth place. They were the third-ranked team in Canada last season and went to the World Championships when Saleh and Pelche couldn't go.
Very handsome team on the ice. Valerie, very tall for a pair skater. Wonderful appearance, but sometimes with the multi-rotation jumps and lifts, those beautiful long legs can get in the way. Not with the twist, though. Side-by-side jumps. Double axle. What a wonderful lift. All the rotational changes, the position changes, each one of those is a threat to the completion of any lift. Can throw the man off balance. Here comes the lift, a hip lift. Down into the landing and stepping right into a throw triple top count. There, even that one. I thought Valerie had it. Thank you.
couple of glitches for them tonight in St. John, New Brunswick. Come the national championships, though, you know that Saret and Fecteau will be one of the teams in contention. And when they get this program tweaked even more, they will be tougher. Still to come, still to skate. The world champions, the leaders after the short program. Team that finished 13th at the World Championships got a chance to go when Jamie Saleh and David Pelche couldn't go because of David's bad back. Said it was a great experience. Tonight wasn't that great of an experience for them here.
It's so hard. When you start doing multiple errors, and this is a team that has really counted on their side-by-side skating, their elements as single skaters have always been very strong. The lifts have gotten better and better over the last year. Now watch as they step Valerie with just one change of foot into the throw triple salchow, a move which even on a bad day they can usually count on.
The marks for
Valerie, 23 years old,
for technical merit.
From Saint-Léonard, Quebec,
four, seven,
and Jean-Sebastian from
four, nine,
Montreal,
four, eight,
born in Thetford Mines. Technical
five,
merit
two,
marks.
Four, eight, five, four.
And then the presentation marks will mean that they will be in second position right now,
five, zero,
behind the Ukrainian
four, six,
team that already
five,
skated.
Three, four,
we
eight,
still have the final
five,
flight
two,
to come.
Five, two, five,
live
four,
here
five,
at
zero,
Harbour Station
five,
tonight. Saret and Fecteau. Their Skate Canada competition is over, but much more to come. Yulia Obertas, Dmitry Palamarchuk already skated earlier. They are the leaders right now, but that's not expected to stay that way for much longer. The final four still to come tonight. Now for our Sun Life time capsule. What year did Tyler Cranston win Skate Canada? Back when our computer graphics on our CTV sports program were at their best. Look at that. The first ever Skate Canada competition. Tyler Cranston won it. The men's event, Ron Shaver was second. A couple of great Canadians. Lynn Nightingale was the women's winner. She works on our broadcast team. In the track. And Karen Magnuson won the worlds. What year was it? We'll tell you when we come back. So the answer to our Sun Life time capsule question, the first ever Skate Canada competition back in 1973, also the year that Karen Magnuson won the World Championships. Well, if you remember at the World Championships in Helsinki, there was a judging scandal that really rocked the skating world. Two judges were suspended after they were tapping their feet. Our cameras caught them conversing and even perhaps conspiring to maybe help some of their own teams. Well, on the heels of that controversy comes perhaps another scandal that involves some international intrigue, a taped conversation, and a Canadian judge caught in the middle and suspended. Debbie Wilkes has more.
Canadian judge Jean Sempt would normally be eligible to sit on the panel here at Skate Canada, but instead of being in St. John, Sempt is watching the event on TV at home, sitting out a 6-month suspension imposed on her by the ISU. In the past, Sempt maintained she has reported two occasions of being pressured by other judges to make deals, incidents which the ISU did not act upon. At the Nagano Olympics, Sempt anticipated it might happen again and came up with a plan that included recording phone conversations from fellow dance judge Yuri Balkov from Ukraine.
I took a tape recorder to Olympics to get proof. The ISU kept saying they could do nothing without proof, so we needed some kind of proof for them to move forward. I do want to say that Mr. Balkov's conduct is not unique. He just happens to be the poor dear soul who called me in my room and was taped. But I took the tape recorder to try and put evidence forth so that the ISU will recognize there really is a problem and do something about it.
One day before she had to judge the free dance, SAMT taped two calls from Ukrainian Judge Balkov, who was also sitting on the Olympic panel, and for the first time has made the actual tapes public. In the first call, Balkov wanted to meet. Fifteen minutes later, a second call from Balkov giving what appears to be directions for placements. Had made the recordings anticipating she would be accused of national bias in marking Born and Kratz. Nothing along that line surfaced immediately, but then a letter from the ISU citing her for just that. SAMT appealed the letter, was turned down, prompting her to take the case to the Court of Arbitration for Sport, something that had never happened before. It was then she revealed she'd made the recordings.
I felt compelled to go that last step to the Court of Arbitration because up till then, the evidence that I had of misconduct had not had a forum for being exposed. And while I did want my national bias citation removed, I also wanted to expose the misconduct because the greater picture needed to be discovered.
The Court of Arbitration for Sport, which you may remember dealt with the Ross Verbigliati matter, in fact did not side with either SEMT or the ISU. Instead, they ruled that in SEMT's case, the ISU had not followed proper procedures, reversed the decision against SEMT, and sent the issue back to the ISU for another hearing. The result of that hearing, where the tapes were considered as evidence, the suspension that SEMT is now serving. The ISU's reason? Because she discussed placements with another judge prior to the Olympic free dance.
Pre-event conversations are not permitted under our rules, and the council determined at the hearing in September that as a consequence of these discussions, which were improper according to the finding of the council, and in violation of the rules, that Ms. Semph would be suspended for 6 months and Mr. Balkov would be suspended for 1 year.
So that's where the issue stands. But there may be a positive side to an otherwise unpleasant situation. This controversy has continued the pressure on skating to deal with its judging procedures.
Well, Debbie, longtime suspicions in any judge sport, but over the last few months we've seen television cameras capture judges and now a phone recording capturing a judge. What gives?
Well, you know, as a result of all this, the ISU has sent a questionnaire to all their international judges, a mandatory questionnaire, by the way, which requires them to report any issues of wrongdoing like this. Personally, I don't know, with SEMT's case being the one to follow, will any judge come forth with any information? However, it is a move forward.
Hard to believe that judges need judges now. My oh my. Here we are now live. Final flight, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman of the United States sitting in fourth place, heading into the free skate.
This pair has all the desire in the world. Relatively new, this is only their second year together. Both experience with other partners. First element, triple toes. Beautiful.
This is the program they've waited 2 years to skate.
And with John, they competed in the 99 championships where they finished ninth in Helsinki.
The making of a great pair rod often takes years of togetherness before it really clicks. Not often does it happen right away. Taking from Tamara Moskovina, they are choreographing a lot of unusual moves in the program, like this squatting spread eagle into the throw. Throw triple loop. Beautiful.
Another unique move.
Back outside death spiral. Neat alteration here in the final movement.
Well, they've got some nice tricks. This program, Phantom of the Opera, was what took them to second place in the U.S. last season and ninth in the world. If they can get everything down and start building towards the Worlds and Nationals, they're going to be up there for sure. Still to come, the Canadian champions on CTV. The Americans, Kyoko Ina and John Zimmerman, awaiting their marks. They train in New Jersey with the Russian world champions, who will skate last. And up next on the ice, Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz. Let's join Rob Falls.
Rod, there was a rumor coming into St. John that Sargent and Wirtz were thinking of turning pro, so I confronted them with it and said, well, what was the situation? Well, Chris looked at me and said, well, to be quite honest, Christy had to be coaxed into returning for this year. We decided, let's have a whole new attitude. We'll come up with the idea of having a lot more fun in our skating and just let things happen. He said, it's the best way for us, if we're going to wrap it up, to do it the way we want to.
Well, interesting. I think there's a real peace in their skating right now. As newlyweds, they recently got married, Christy and Chris, and it's almost as if, you know, they've always kind of had this pressure over top of them, and now that they're two-time champions, perhaps going for a third, maybe they just said, hey, let's just go for it this year. They're up next. Now Ina and Zimmerman.
This was a good skate for this couple. The one they've been looking for.
5-4, 5-5.
It's a good
mark. Very good marks.
5-5, 5-5, 5-5, 5-4, 5-5, 5-6. The marks for
presentation. Even though there have been some very good elements in the past with this team, they have been looking to get together. Their styles have been very different. At last, I feel like they made it.
Connection time.
You're right.
They're getting there. And right now, they're on top of the leaderboard. They are first.
Our next competitors representing Canada, Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz.
Last time they won a Skate Canada, 5 years ago. Could they do it again? Can they knock off the world champions? They will need a clean skate.
Their strong points, their throws, and the death spirals, exquisite. Weakest elements, the triple twist. Rotation complete, however, not as fast moving across the ice surface as some of the other pairs. Triple toes. Often pair skaters will speak to each other during the program, particularly on the side-by-side spins, and always if there's a new decision to be made about leaving something out or changing choreography in any way. Lifts when they come down.
You've been there before.
Oh, yeah. I think this is a very clever selection in terms of music. It's Debussy Clair de Lune. The gentleness of the music and the emotion of the music works very well for Chris and Christy. They have been criticized in the past for being
rather one-dimensional in their expression, and I think it gives them a lot of richness and texture. Death spiral. Watch the separate entry. Wonderful choreography.
Not quite the Sergeant and Wirtz that we saw at the Nationals the last couple of years, catapulting them to the top in the country, but they still have time to work on it.
They do, and I think an important thing about this particular program, it was not technically perfect by any means, but they didn't let the program fall apart. They still kept the tension, the feeling, and the expression of the music.
And the world champions still ahead, Elena Berezhnaya, Anton Sigalitsi. In the background, Paul Wirtz, the coach, Marina Zueva, the choreographer, Christy Sargent, and Chris Wirtz.
They had some problems beginning with the side-by-side triple toes. Christy decided to do simply a double, which, considering she may have fallen if she had attempted a triple, it was probably a good decision. Here is the throw triple Salchow. Started out beautifully, has wonderful height. And she hangs on. It wasn't pretty, but she made it. Now here is the lift that caused me to be so scared. Seemed to go up nicely. Then the position was not directly over top of Chris. Watch his expression. Oh, wiping his brow. Those can be nasty.
The marks for Christy Sargent.
A team that's always been very intense, and I think that, again, I guess I go back to what I said about being at peace more. I think they're realizing that it doesn't really matter in the scheme of things as long as they do their best or try to do their best.
Well, think back a year ago at Skate Canada in Kamloops when they did not have a particularly great skate and they stormed off the Kiss and Cry area. Here they are, they're cracking jokes with one another. They seem as if they really do have it in perspective, and that's going to make, in the long term, for better skating.
Sign of maturity.
Thank you.
And their mark's not good enough to keep them ahead of Ina and Zimmerman, who currently are the leaders. With two teams
to skate.
Our next competitors
from China, Qing Peng and Jian Tong.
Here is Qing Peng and Jian Tong. They were third and arguably could have even been first last night had they not had a slip up at the end of the program. And really, Berezhnaya and Sigalitsi had a couple of gifts from the judges.
No, I think that is a consensus around here. And certainly keep your eye on this team because if they have a great skate, and perhaps a little help from Berezhnaya and Sigalitsi, these could be the Skate Canada winners. Technically, they are superb. The very first element will be the triple twist. Watch the unusual air position. She is in a lateral position, lying horizontal to the ice.
Wow.
Love it. A lot of ice.
Debbie, China has become such a power now in pair skating. When you were skating, were there any Chinese pairs teams around?
Not that I ever competed against. And I don't really, I think it's only been in the last few years. This team trains with the world silver medalist, Shannon Zhao. And you see a lot of the same kind of technique on the lift, her legs more arched behind, which can be both good and bad. Behind, the upper part of the body bends to the ice. Of the music.
They aren't quite there with their countrymen, Shannon Zhao, who were the Skate Canada champions a year ago. But I have a feeling they could get there, Debbie.
They've certainly got all the moves. The technical stuff is very strong.
Their marks and then one team to skate. Elena and Anton, the world champions, are next. And here is the Chinese team, Qian Pang and Jian Tong.
Rod, have a look at this triple twist. They go 100 miles an hour into it, very quick into the toe pick. Look at how her split makes her lie horizontal to the ice. Makes it kind of interesting when it comes to the catch.
They have such tremendous speed, both this team and the world silver medalists.
Here the leg positions are arched back, which can make the lift more difficult because there is a torque from the weight of her legs and feet. The throw triple loop went up beautifully, but watch how the free leg kicks behind and the body has to drop forward like a teeter-totter.
For technical merit.
So the marks
5-3, 5-6,
here will determine 5-3, also 5-0, if Christy Sargent 5-6, and Chris Wirtz will make it 5-3, to the podium
5-3,
here
5-4,
at this Sun Life Skate 5-6. Canada International. Technical merit marks 5-6 there. Presentation, they are third.
4-9,
so Sargent
5-4,
and Wirtz will finish 5-0, no worse 5-1, than third. They will 5-4, take the bronze medal,
5-2,
or maybe even
5-1,
a silver.
5-3,
remember
5-2.
That from the short program, these thank ordinals you are all over the place.
So now it's up to the world champions to show that they are indeed and skating backstage, like world champions.
Well, backstage, Rod, there was very little discussion between them. Notice they're not even
our
holding hands here. There's something definitely
Russia.
Wrong.
Elena Bereznaya and Anton Siorlice.
They had the benefit last night. You see their coach, Tamara Moskvina. He had the benefit last night. Even though they committed four very peculiar errors for
big
world
ones.
Champions, they were still rewarded and given first place. Now, they're free skate.
Triple toes to start. Very nice. Maybe this will give them a bit of a lift. And speaking of lifts, here is their triple twist coming. The best in the world. Giving up this title easily, Rob.
Season, their quality is in a completely different league, isn't it?
It takes my breath away, actually. The softness and gentleness, you have no sense of difficulty, even when they're going that 100 miles an hour, doesn't look like they're even pushing. That is quality. Go up with no effort, corner to corner on the ice surface. And always punctuated with the most beautiful positions and original choreography. Another one, a throw triple loop to add to the list of successful elements. This was the point last weekend at Skate America where the program fell apart.
Thank you. thought the judges were very generous. Tonight, no brainer. They're the champs.
A little kiss and makeup.
That's more like it. Tonight you saw why they are world champions. And that quality unrivaled. Berezhnaya and Sigerlitsy, the obvious is next, the gold medal. I guess they answered our questions. We don't have to be concerned. Yes, sometimes you can struggle, sometimes you can have disputes, but when you have to lay it down, you can lay it down, and they did.
Starting with this beautiful triple twist, the side-by-side triple toes were terrific too. Set the mood for the program. They got into it, and more they started to communicate. They started to feel the need of each other and what was required to make these amazing elements happen.
Last week they were upset by Jamie Saleh and David Pelletier of Canada. Tonight, even though they've been upset perhaps with their performance and each other, nothing like it here. They're the winners.
Every skater goes through that. Everybody has a time when they think, what am I doing this for? As if it was over.
Anton said earlier that it was a snowball coming at them. Well, alleviated tonight by this performance. Not perfect, but much better than last night. No doubt about it. They are the winners. Ina and Zimmerman of the U.S. take second. Christy Sargent and Chris Wirtz finish third. Berezhnaya and Sigerlitsy, world champions, Sun Life Skate Canada international champions for 1999.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the judging of the Paris
that
event.
Was nice.
The unofficial standings are as follows. In first place from
strong
Russia,
strong finish, and I'm happy and that it happened for them. Now maybe they can put that behind, and on they go. And
John Zimmerman. Here are the standings.
In third place from Canada,
American team skated well tonight, too. Sargent and Wirtz have some work to do. And the other Canadian teams, Surrette and Fecteau, and Larivier and Faustino. And now let's join Rob.
With the third place finishers at Skate Canada, what's your reaction?
Well, I think that overall the result was good. I mean, to come third or first or second would have been, it's always good, but we have some work to do. I mean, our skating wasn't exactly where we wanted it to be, but we're pleased how we handled the week. We approached it professionally, and we're leaving with some good things and some bad things, and a bronze medal for our daughter.
Now, tell me about the bronze for Tristan.
Yeah, actually, before we came here, she said, you know, you don't have a bronze medal. I've never seen a bronze medal, so if you can't bring home a bronze medal, so it's all her fault.
Oh, you're such good parents. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Sometimes it isn't about getting the gold, but bringing home the bronze. They are. Tomorrow night, Elvis Stoiko, the men's free skate, head-to-head with Alexei Yagudin in the dance free skate tomorrow night, too. Be with us. Sports Central up the dial on Sportsnet. We'll have a wrap-up from here. St. John, New Brunswick. A lot of great skating. Last night, the pairs did not deliver. Tonight, they did. Berezhnaya and Sigerlitsy were great. Sargent and Wirtz are going home with the bronze for Tristan. For Debbie Wilkes and Tracy Wilson and Rob Falls, this is Rod Black.